Well, what do you know?
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 In front of
In the years after starting Here, Starting Now, without any particular purpose, I began to construct a kind of a file. People would tell me interesting stories that seemed worth, being a song. And I just sort of, I'd write a description of it and I'd just put it in this file, and every now and then I'd take it out. And then sometimes David and I would get together and we would actually take the idea and shape it into a song, and then I'd work on it every now and then. And we began to construct this collection of portraits, really, of
story,
of story songs of modern life, with no real purpose as to what it would be. The Manhattan Theater Club was then doing decided to do a sort of a book-oriented, a playwright-oriented review called Urban Blight, and they wanted some songs for it. And we played their songs and our songs, and they took all of them. And so we put some of them in that show. And then from that came the idea of doing it in a nightclub. Actually, my assistant, Stephen Scott Smith, put it together. And it was surprising again to see how these songs added up to a portrait of
that demographic
of a demographic, I guess, of a certain age. If Starting Here, Starting Now is all kind of young love, this was all about people who've been around the block once. This was the second time around. This is the people who'd married and divorced and now were married again. People who'd gone through some things. And I know that when Stephen Holden wrote his review of the album in the Times, he said that it was amazingly adult, this show. It was these story songs about people that really existed. And it's not surprising that they came off that way, because they were from people who really existed. Plus, of course, things that we had experienced from our own life.
And then Austin Pendleton, who was then the director of the Williamstown Theater, suggested that we bring the show up to Williamstown again, which has always been a second home for us, and work on the show up there, like an out-of-town tryout. And from there, and we added some songs, replaced some songs, and from there it went into, it led to a off-Broadway production. We are not, by the way, enamored of the review form. It's funny that we never sat down and said, let's write a review. But we wind up being known largely for two reviews. But especially with Closer Than Ever, we think of it as kind of a volume of short stories. 25 short stories put together on the stage.